everyone, and welcome to our history lesson for today. Today we will be learning about VE Day, or Victory in Europe Day. So we've got some vocabulary that you might need to know before we go any further. So victory is defeating an enemy or winning. Europe is a continent in the Northern Hemisphere. We live in Europe. Allies are someone, in this context, a country who's on your side. To surrender means to give up. And the wireless is similar to a radio. People listen to the wireless to listen to important announcements that were made. Very few people had televisions at this time. So Victory in Europe Day, or VE Day as it's more well known, took place on May the 8th, 1945. It was a public holiday and a day of celebration to mark the defeat of Germany by the Allied forces in World War II. VE Day marked the formal conclusion of the war with Germany and brought to an end 6 long years of suffering, courage and endurance across the world. After Hitler died in April 1945, the Germans knew that they could not win the war. General Jodl travelled to see General Dwight Eisenhower, who was Supreme Commander of the Allied Forces in Europe at the headquarters in France. On the 7th of May at 2:41 a.m, in front of some of the leaders of the Western Allies, Jodl signed a surrender document on behalf of Germany. This meant that the war in Europe was over, although World War II continued in other countries. As news of the surrender spread, the war-weary British began to rejoice straight away. During the previous 6 years, 500,000 homes had been destroyed, thousands of civilians had been killed, and many millions of lives had been disrupted in Britain alone. The news of a surrender was what everyone needed to hear. People ran out onto the streets, hanging bunting and banners and dancing. People organised street parties, shared rationed food with neighbours, and listened to the wireless for updates. Yet the British Prime Minister, Winston Churchill, had yet to make a formal announcement. He was being held back by Stalin, the leader of the Soviet Union. Stalin wanted his own document of surrender signing, so he was holding off announcing the fall of Germany. Churchill was not going to give Stalin the satisfaction of making Britain wait, so at 1940, Churchill made this announcement over the radio. In accordance with arrangements between the three great powers, tomorrow, Tuesday, will be treated as Victory in Europe Day and will be regarded as a holiday. This photograph shows Churchill waving to crowds in Whitehall, London, on the day he broadcast to the nation that the war with Germany had been won, 8th of May, 1945. So many bombing raids, London was the place to be on VE Day, and anyone who could reach the city did so. The centre of London was full of people wearing red, white and blue, waving flags, dancing and singing. Fireworks filled the sky with flashes of light. On VE Day, everyone, both in London and at home, sitting by their wireless sets, wanted to hear just one man, Winston Churchill. Crowds gathered in Trafalgar Square and up the Mall, waiting for Winston Churchill and King George VI to make an appearance on the balcony of Buckingham Palace. At 3 p.m., the Prime Minister broadcast to the nation. He praised the British spirit and reminded them that this was a victory of the great British nation as a whole. He also reminded them that the war continued against the Japanese, but we can all take a night off today.
Yesterday morning at 2:41 a.m. at General Eisenhower's headquarters, General Jodl, the representative of the German High Command, and of Grand Admiral Dönitz, the designated head of the German state, signed the act of unconditional surrender of all German land, sea, and air forces in Europe to the Allied expeditionary forces and simultaneously to the Soviet High Command. Hostilities will end officially at 1 minute after midnight tonight, Tuesday, the 8th of May. We may allow ourselves a brief period of rejoicing. Today is Victory in Europe Day. Tomorrow will also be Victory in Europe Day. But let us not forget for a moment the toils and efforts that lie ahead. Japan, with all her treachery and greed, remains unsubdued. The injuries she has inflicted upon Great Britain, the United States, and other countries, and her detestable cruelties call for justice and retribution. We must now devote all our strength and resources to the completion of our tasks, both at home and abroad. Advance, Britannia! Long live the cause of freedom! God save the King!
Shortly after Churchill's speech, King George VI, Queen Elizabeth and the two princesses came out onto the balcony at Buckingham Palace. It was to be the first of 8 appearances by the King and Queen on VE Day. When the doors onto the balcony were opened again at 17:30, the royal family stepped out accompanied by the man of the hour, Churchill. Churchill later told the crowds, "This is your victory." Later that evening, Princess Elizabeth and Princess Margaret slipped out of Buckingham Palace to experience the celebrations for themselves. They stood amongst the joyful crowds below the royal balcony. Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II recalled the event. "My sister and I realised we couldn't see what the crowds were enjoying, so we asked my parents if we could go out and see for ourselves. After crossing Green Park, we stood outside and shouted, 'We want the King!' and we were successful in seeing my parents on the balcony. I think it was one of the most memorable nights of my life." So I'd like you to think about some questions now about what you've just seen and heard. You can pause the video after each question and discuss or write your answers, or you can listen to all three and then do the same. So, what is remembered on VE Day? Why do you think it's important to celebrate and recognise VE Day? And how do you think VE Day should be celebrated? Is there anything that we can do to celebrate or remember at this current time? Click the next page to see some activities that you could do to help you remember VE Day. You can choose as many activities as you would like to. You could create your own Spitfire glider. There is a template on Seesaw if you'd like to use this. You could try Morse code cracking. Again, there's a template on Seesaw if you'd like to do this. You could write a newspaper article about VE Day. You could plan a VE Day garden party for your family. Maybe you could bake some treats for this. And you could create some bunting. You could possibly use this for your garden party if you are planning to have one. We would love to see these, so please do post them to Seesaw.